The German Research Center for Artificial Intelligence and the country's Saarland University are putting 3D graphics on the web. The system they've developed, called XML3D, allows for 3D models to be embedded and interactive on websites. It's an extension to HTML, the web's basic language.
The advantage is that you can interact between normal HTML and 3D scenes, so every web designer, and there are thousands of web designers all around the world, can directly use this technology without learning anything new. They can use the same techniques on 3D elements as they've done with normal HTML elements before.
At this week's CEBIT IT Fair in Hanover, they're showing the system for the first time in a modified version of the Firefox browser. A 3D model of a Venetian palace is embedded into a Wikipedia page and can be navigated and controlled with a mouse. It's this integration with HTML and web browsers that the developers believe make it a better alternative to competing technologies that require learning a new programming language. In developing XML3D, researchers came up with their own method for interpreting 3D images for 2D screens, rather than using rasterization, which is a common method used in computer games.
There are some certain limitations. It's very hard to do shadows and reflections correctly. What we use here is a technique that we developed called interactive real-time ray tracing, and that actually simulates the physics of light in an environment. So whenever we generate an image, right, it's physically correct.
The next step will be the release of a modified version of Firefox with support for XML3D, so that web developers can try the technology for themselves. That should appear in the next couple of weeks at xml3d.org.
We see a big potential here, and we've built the technology, and now we're looking for partners, right, because we can't do everything alone.
The German Research Center for Artificial Intelligence is supported by big-name companies, and some of them, including Intel and SAP, have already seen demonstrations of the system.
We don't really know what it will be. It's pretty much like the internet at the beginning.
At CEBIT 2010 in Hanover, Germany, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.